Do you want to move on to the next level? You understand strings and lists and even dictionaries, but you want to know what to use, how to use it, and when. So to start off with, what is a data structure? It's a type of store, a structure that holds items. In Python, there are different types of collections, which is basically a form of storage that you can add and remove items. Things like strings and lists, we've also mentioned dictionaries and sets and tuples. So strings, you would think of normal text, that would be a string. A list, the same as in real life, a list, which really is a collection of items. So here we have a collection of words. If we had the words with spaces, like a normal sentence, we would probably use a string. But in this case, we want the separate words. Do we want a string or a list? Well, in this case, we want the individual words. We want a list. Here's a collection of passport numbers. So do we need a list? Well, the passport numbers need to be unique. So we want a set, so there's no duplicates, so not a list. Here's some scores. 81, 79, 73 and 78. But whose scores are they? So in this instance, this case, we want the person's name who got the score. So we can use a dictionary called scores that has, if you like, a label with their name attached to the score. So you can remember we have a dictionary of scores. We mentioned sets, which are like a list, but they don't have duplicates. You can't sort them. Tuples, a bit like a list again, don't really have so much functions. And then immutables, you can't change the items. So we have in computer science different data structures. Not the data structures we've seen like lists and dictionaries and strings that are built into Python. But we do need these different types of storage, and they're based on real life scenarios. So for example, a queue. We have a queue of people, we have people join the back, and then people leave off the front. So that's a queue. A stack, we add to a stack by putting it on top. And if we want to take something off, we have to take it off from the top. If we want on the bottom, we have to take all the things on top off first. So that's a stack. A heap is an ordered queue, by the way. So you think of a queue as someone entering it at the end, at the back, and exiting it at the front. And a stack, you enter, you put on the top, and you take off the top. So these are slightly different. And why is that important? Well, when you want to solve a problem, you might need to store things either temporarily over a long period of time, but you need the correct structure, the correct storage. So what does that mean? Okay, let's have a problem and try to solve it. Here's a maze. The entry is to the left as you look at it. So we enter and we choose our option either to go left or right. And then we follow through the maze, and then we have another option to go left or right. We follow through the maze again, another option to go left or right. If we choose the wrong option, we end up in a dead end. So we have to go back to our last choice. Hopefully, at some point, we get the maze correct and we come out the exit. This is a quite simple example of a maze. So let's have a look. Here we've got three places where we make a choice of left or right. So we've got 1, 2, and 3, then exit. So we've got a choice of left or right, and left or right. So we choose left, then left again, Then we get blocked, a dead end. So we go back and choose right, and then left again, and then we come out of our exit. So let's have a look at our data structures. What about a stack? Well, we started off going left, then we went left again, then that left was wrong, so we take that out and put in right. Then we go left, and then we had the exit. So the stack worked. We had left, left, then we took that out, right, then left, to finish with the solution, left, right, left. So in terms of what we're doing just with the stack, first of all, we push. So when we enter something, it's called push. So we're going to push in left, you're going to push in left again, then we're going to pop out left because it was wrong, so that's exiting. So that's pop, and then we're going to push right, and then we're going to push left again, and then we have our correct solution, left, right, left. So we can push and pop into our stack, and it works. What about our queue? So here we've got a queue going from left to right. So left is at the front of the queue, right is the back of the queue. So we're going to push in our left, then we're going to push in another left. We're going to pop that out, goes out the back. Then we're going to push in a right, and then we're going to push in a left. So that gives us our left, right, left. But that didn't work the right way. Because with a queue, remember, when something leaves the queue, it leaves from the front. So we pushed in left from the end of the queue. So there's no one in the queue, so that's the first item in the queue, left. Then we push in left again, so that's the second left, the second one in the queue. So when something exits from the queue, when it's popped, it comes from the front. When someone's in a queue and they want to leave the queue, they leave from the front. So that's how a queue works. So that left is wrong. That's wrong. So the other method of using a stack would work, but this method of using a queue is not appropriate to solving the problem with the maze. Okay, I hope you understood that. It was an example of how different structures can be used for different things. Trees and graphs. So here's a tree. We have A is at the top, the root, and it has children, B and C. C has a child, F, and B has two children, D and E. This is also a data structure that you use quite a lot. So you might see it in real life with a family tree or an organizational chart. But essentially it has something at the top, and this has children. You can call these nodes, and each node can have children, can have one or more, and we go down the tree. Now, a graph is different. A graph, if you like, is like a tree, but the children can go back up. So here we've got several nodes, and they're all connected. So this is kind of like a silic graph, like a circle. Here we've got another graph, so some nodes are connected and some are not. But it's not a tree, there's not one at the top, some going down. So therefore, if you like, a parent can have children, and those children could be parents of other children. So it's not really a tree, it's a graph. So a graph we can connect between any node to another node. So these are two data structures we haven't seen yet, but just wanted to show you them. And in real life, for example, we can have maps. So if you want to connect cities in the world, that would be a graph, or even a diagram of an underground is a graph. Yeah, you can think of the stations as nodes, and the lines, the train lines or even bus lines, are the connecting lines between these nodes. So the graph has nodes, and in between lines are called arcs. Okay, that's it for part one. We're going to explain a bit about what we've introduced a bit more in part two. I hope you enjoyed today's video and join us for part two. Thank you. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Bye for now.